Hey there, so in this video I'm going to show you how I took this old cardboard and tinfoil parabolic trough cooker, the one I made like 3 or 4 years ago, and turned it into something a lot better. Something that looks like this. Now it's got the fully mirrorized surface with actual glass mirror. It's got the 5 skewer levels for cooking, high, medium, and low. Even has the little wooden handles on the skewers. All super easy to make. I'll show you how to do it. Quick demonstration of the cooking power here. Those are those gigantic marshmallows. 3 of them on there. Notice the evenness of the brown. It's usually not that even when you cook over a fire. At least not when I do it. I got black spots. They catch fire and stuff. These won't catch fire on here. Look about done to me. So I started by removing the backing. Then you just rock the edges back and forth and snap them off. And that leaves you with the mirror. Alright, I think I'm going to go with the 1-inch strips because that cut perfect. Again, the mirror is so thin in these cheap mirrors, it's great. Just pops right along the line. Alright, that's the entire mirror cut down. Now I'm just going to glue them in. And then we'll put some small ones on the top and the bottom, and we're set. Alright, let's go ahead and add the side support now. So 3.5 inches, that's the width of the cooker, and the focal point is 4.5 inches up. So that'll be at 8, and then we'll add a couple just to clear it.
Oh, forget this. Let's move.
Alright, so now I've got it at the exact focal point, the 4.5 inches, completely centered, and it's smooth as glass. Alright, so the next thing I did was cut it down, so it's about that size, and I made a little wooden handle for it.
Then just drill a hole, add a little bit of glue, and kind of jam it in there.
So there it is. Came out awesome. Sweet shot right there. It got the 3 handles. These are just some shorter extra pieces, but you got the 5 total spots. That's just to hold them from slipping out when I move it around. The middle one's the exact focal point of this, and then you got medium heat here or here, and then low heat would be here or the last hole in the bottom. Those rods are getting super hot, and the sun's only like 50% out right now. Maybe 70 max. It's kind of weak. mid-November, freezing out here, about 45. Fitting the rods perfectly. Let's give it a try. One thing I noticed about cooking the marshmallows on the solar like this is they come out really, really evenly brown. Nothing like when you do it on the fire. Check out how even that is. We're gonna lose that one here in a second. These things are so big. Beautiful. They've been on there probably 10, 15 minutes. I've turned them 3 or 4 times. They get nice and even brown. Keep thinking they're gonna fall off, but they never do. So this thing should cook like meats, vegetables, hot dogs. Maybe even hamburger if you like roll it up in the shape of a hot dog and jam it on the skewer. Again, looks like it would cost a lot, but it cost me like nothing. The basic design was just $5 for the mirror and a couple bucks for the cardboard. That was about it. I had some scrap pieces to make these. I did buy the dowels, those were $2 a piece, but by the way, one thing I want to stress again, highly important, put little notches in here so you don't have to slide it through the center. Make like a 45-degree notch on each one of these so that you can slide the bar down into the hole that you drilled. That way you can lift these out again easily. Otherwise, you have to like move it out, take the food off kind of in the middle, take the whole thing out. It's one of those things. You can do it this way, but add the notches, you'll be happier.
Alright, so this is the super compressed version of when I built this cooker 3 or 4 years ago. If you want to see the actual video, I'll put the link in the description below, or you could just check my channel. The one thing I didn't do with this one is right at the very end, I just covered it with tin foil, but later on, I ripped off the tin foil, put down some poster board, and then recovered it with the tin foil just for a smoother finish. So you'd want to do that if you're going to use the glass.
Tinfoil is optional, but actually, I highly recommend it. Originally, I made this with the tinfoil and then just covered it with the glass, but if you do spill anything on the glass, it's super easy to wipe up. And if you have the tinfoil underneath, then anything liquid's not going to get on the cardboard, so it's really a good idea to use the tinfoil anyway.